I'm sitting here now with Jan Higginbotham, who's mostly a painter. Jan, what are your two, oil or acrylic?
Oil is what I work in mostly. I also work a little bit in gouache, which is a water-based paint that's sort of halfway between acrylic and watercolor. It's a thick watercolor. Mainly I work though in oil. I worked in oil-based clay as a sculptor for decades and decades before I began.
How have you blended being a sculptor and a painter?
Very, very good question. Actually, these days, I'm using my sculptures as models for my paintings. And this was one of the bigger sculptures that I've done in recent years. It's bigger than this painting. And it's a quite abstract piece. And it sits in the studio in plaster. So it has been posing quite willingly for several of my paintings.
So, I was going to say, do you paint like in an abstract style or a representational style? But for instance, if you're painting a piece of sculpture and the sculpture's abstract and you're painting it in a representational style, but what do you prefer?
You know, these days I'm moving more into abstraction, which is exactly what I did in sculpture. I went from realism and classical sculpture to more abstracted figurative sculpture, and I'm doing the very same thing in painting. They went from, as I was learning to paint, they were realistic and mostly still lifes, and I still enjoy doing those, but I'm also really having fun with these things that look more abstract.
Do you find that you paint one-offs, or do you paint like in a series, like for a month you've been painting fruit or?
Right now I seem to be painting in a series. I've been working from this one piece of sculpture now for probably 6 months or more. And I also simultaneously, I work on different pieces simultaneously, so I have some others going that are of other pieces that are unfinished. But this is a finished one.
Money is no object and the piece is available. What's the piece of art that you'd like to have come to your house?
Gosh. So many things I would love to grab if I could.
Just give us one.
Give me one.
So, oh well.
Okay, so I'm going to go for a Diebenkorn piece, a Diebenkorn painting, a sizable, and I don't even know which one.
Okay, that's fine. What's the first piece of art you see when you wake up in the morning?
Well, I creep out of the bedroom very early, so. It's a Japanese woodblock on the wall in the hallway. As I'm leaving the bedroom and closing the dark bedroom door, I see that one when I turn on the light.
Do you recall selling your first piece of art?
My first piece probably sold through a gallery, and so I wasn't there. It was a sculpture that sold through a gallery. I remember being very, very excited, but I didn't have an experience with the purchase.
So a studio tour, friends and people you've never met before can come on in and see your work, and I think that opens us all up to getting new potential collectors or admirers or.
Absolutely. Studio tour is a wonderful thing. I love doing it for fun. This is our brand new way to do it. And I'm excited about this. I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you very much, Jen.
Thank you.